In some applications, you need to control a servo motor based on a signal. The signal could be status of some value change or status of a push button. So this is a push button that I'm using to press and move the servo. And as long as it is pushed, the servo will go within the boundary of 0 to 180 degrees. And so this has a lot of application. Depending on the type of application that you use, this code will be very useful. Here is the wiring for the servo with the push button. The same as before, the yellow has been connected to 9. The middle pin is connected to the 5 volts, the red one, and then the darker color is connected to the ground. That was for the servo. For the push button, on one side have been connected to the ground, and the other side have been connected to pin 2. Here for the servo, with the orange, I put yellow, I've been connected to pin 9, that's a pulse width modulation pin. The middle pin is VCC, via red have been connected to 5 volts. I've used another brown, connected to the ground. Here is my push button. My push button has 2, as before I mentioned. If you have this type of push button, you can use it, but make sure that once you connect it this way, if it doesn't work, rotate it 90 degrees, should work. So I have 2 wires here for the push button. One wire is connected to pin 2, the other is connected to ground. Now let me explain the code. As before, we have to include the servo.h, which I've explained it in a previous video. And then we use the class servo. We create an instance of it when we call it my servo. This line defines pin 9 as a servo pin. And this line defines push button pin at pin 2. The angle is the initial angle that when you start it, the servo will go to. This value is the step of angle when you push the button. It jumps continuously, or every time you push it, it goes 10. If you want it 5 or lower or maybe higher, just change it accordingly. Inside the setup, we define the serial monitor with 9600 baud, and then we use the servo.attach servo pin. This have been defined here, and we attach the servo pin 9 to the servo, and then we also define the push button pin. We are using input pull-up to avoid using extra resistor, and then we print the sticks on the screen. This portion of the code will run only once. Inside the loop, this portion will run continuously. The first line, it says while, as I've explained it, is will run as long as this is true, which means as long as the result of digital read push button, this will read the push button pin 2, the result, and we'll compare it with low. As long as this is true, as long as this is low, or as long as the button is pushed, then this code will be executed up to here. You see this square? That's end of while. Now let's see what happens. First we get the angle. This is 90 degrees, that angle, and then plus the angle step, 90 plus 10, we make it 100. And then the job of this portion is, as explained before, to keep the servo between 0 and 180. And then we use my servo.write angle, the angle that we have, we will write it here. And because this code runs only when the button is pushed, then we have to also display what angle the servo is moving to. So this will move, and also the same angle will be printed on the serial monitor. At the end also we put degree, so the user knows it's degree. And then we wait 100 milliseconds, and the while continues inside the loop. This loop will not be executed until you release the button. When the button is released, this will be false, and while loop will exit, and it will come back, and continuously will check the push button. As soon as you push it, it will react, and this code will be executed, whatever the while loop. Here is a demonstration of controlling a servo motor with a push button. The serial monitor is also open. The code is running. When I press the button, it shows the angle here. And as long as I press it, it goes between 0 to 180 and returns back. It reaches to 180 and it goes back. Every time I press it, it jumps with a step. If I hold it, it just continuously going between 0 and 180. And if I release it at any moment, it shows the angle that it was released at. Now this is around 20 and it goes 180 on the other side. Now let's set this to 5 degrees. Then it means that the resolution have increased, which means every step that this was before taking at 10 degrees, now it will go by 5 degrees. The code have been uploaded. Now as you can see, every time I push it, it jumps. And this jump also refers to that step of 5. Now it jumps every time with 5 degrees.